Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this brown box. This is the U7 Outdoor. Interesting fact that when you adopt this into your controller, it will probably be called the UK Pro. And you won't see the words at the moment, U7 Outdoor. Why? Because this device looks like and is the sort of the next one up of the UK Ultra, the UK Ultra being the Wireless 5. This is about three times larger than that unit, but it is the same sort of style and form factor. But we'll have a look at the unit properly in a moment. It's not gonna be a big technical overview. I do wanna just show you what you get in the box. So this is a U7 access point, a Wireless 7 access point that does support Wireless 6 and Wireless 5 as well. And in the box, all right, you are going to get your little conformity guide, which you probably will put aside and never read. So that's a good starting point. There you are going to get a little guide that reminds you this can be run in two options. It has external antennas on it, and you can run that in 360 degrees signal, or you can run it without the antennas and it's much more of a directional signal. You are going to get two metal zip ties here for being able to clip that to a post, and you're going to get a number of screws and lugs to be able to fit all of that together. You're going to get your two antennas that we talked about, which I'll show you on the unit in due course. You are going to get a level and drilling guide for both this back plate, and I'll show you how this fits together. You're also going to get some wall mounting plates as well. So the idea for this is going to be drilled and fixed to your wall. You can then put this nice, neat, tidy plate over if you want to, just to keep the water out of it. And then you get this backing plate. So the backing plate's needed whether you have pole mounted. So as you can see, if I just turn that around like this, sorry, I got the angles wrong. You can see here the grooves for pole mounting. So once that's mounted on the pole, you would then just put your metal zip tie around that side of it, and actually screw that into place or tighten that up into place against the pole. Alternatively, you can mount this onto your wall plate. So this is mounted on the wall. This will come up and screw into place there. All right, and then I'll show you in due course how this actually fits onto the device. But I know what you really want to look at. You actually want to get to look at the device. It is pretty big, as you can see. Probably if I just hold it up here, just so you can see the size of that. It's a good size unit. It's composite construction. It is pretty heavy. You can just see here its layout. And just turn on the side, we can see some of the LED indicators that we've got here. And then we can see this big, I don't know whether it is solid metal or whether it's got a coating on it, but a big solid heat sink over the back of it. All right. And then this is where our mounting will happen. So if we're using this bracket here, which obviously could mount to the pole or whichever way. Once we've actually mounted this either to the wall or the pole, then we can actually bring that up and slide that into place, and it's going to click into place and our cable can be fed in from the bottom. And that's our release button on the back of that. So just so you can have a look at that, you can, as you can see, the release button here, and then you can see where the cable will come through at the bottom. We then do have a bung here in place that we can take out. We've got obviously got our reset hole in there, and we've got our Ethernet in. This is PoE powered, remember, PoE plus powered. We've got a retaining screw. So once our bracket has pushed all the way into place, then obviously we can screw that into place. And we do have a releasing option here if we need to as well. So the idea is you're obviously going to pass your cable through the split. Let me just put that down. The split in here, all right, and through, and then again through the split in this bung, and then going to clip it into place here. Then if we just switch this round this way, we can see over on this side here, we can take these two off, and the antennas are included in the box. So let's just put those antennas on there for you to get an idea of how that goes. Here we go. All right. And then that is your device. Obviously, we've got our angling options that we can do on this to move it to the sides or this way. And that will actually allow you to do what's needed to give you 360 degrees coverage from that. So hopefully that's been useful to have a look at. That is the U7 Outdoor. Head on over to our YouTube channel. Got plenty more box openings on network wireless and firewall devices, so subscribe and stay up to date.